Także będzie materiał. Baza Straży Pożarnej ze Chicago Fire z telewizji. To jest. Jesteśmy w Chicago. Taki mam widok. No coś pięknego. Jak tu byłem 2 lata temu, to tutaj akurat kręcili zdjęcia. Do filmu nie dało się w ogóle przejść. Z głupkami się po prostu człowiek bił. Oczywiście sekundę tutaj byłem sam i już po prostu 2000 ludzi po prostu się przepieprzyło. Ja tam nie będę wchodził jak ci idioci. Na pewno to wróci. Dużo, mamy helikopter nad głową. Także jak ktoś lubi Chicago Fire, to se może zobaczyć. Znaczy oni tutaj wjeżdżają i od razu parkują z drugiej strony. Nic nie widać w środku. Idziemy się zapytać, czy nas wpuszczą zrobić parę zdjęć, film opowiedzieć przejazdem. Hello. Wow. Nie, po prostu żeśmy tutaj wleźli tak po prostu. Ale będzie materiał. I feel strange, like everybody else was okay on the inside.
Oh, I'm sure they're used to it.
Jasność jest do kitu trochę. The last time when I watched the episode, it was 4 years ago, 5, when I was in my Dream Master Studios. I don't remember exactly. Is it exactly that track, or is that on views?
I don't watch it enough to know.
Nie wierzę, że mi się tu udało wejść po 2 latach, tak po prostu. Także no to jest vlog, bo akurat jest wycieczka, jest w Chicago. Jeszcze nie obrobiłem sobie filmików jeszcze z poprzedniej wycieczki 2 lata temu, po prostu nie mam czasu. Ale... coś pięknego. Thank you.
Thanks.
Valor. Willen, guzik widać. So how, which year the show started and you started to be abused by
it? I don't know, because I just transferred over here in October, so I'm like, I haven't really watched the show, I'll be honest. Like, whatever, I've caught like bits and pieces of it, but you ask me a question, I'll maybe know the answer.
Like I said, we just don't remember, we know that Chicago Fire Station is exactly here, so it's where we are just, by the way, coming to on the trip.
Right.
So we just wanted to see.
Actually, one of our firefighters, who used to be, he's from Poland, and he's actually going back to Poland today to be there for like a month and a half. Yeah. So I'm just like, man, darn it, you guys are like messing up.
Send him a greetings from Silesian guy. Remember, Silesian guy.
Silesian guy?
Yes. Okay. It's like state of Poland, so
okay.
And the south part of the south Polish guys.
Oh, he's been excited to meet you and stuff.
Great, amazing. Oh, it's Polish stations, they probably are not, first, they are not open to the public any.
Yeah, well, I mean, per our orders, like all of our firehouses can be open to the public to about, I would say 8 o'clock, 9
but
o'clock.
Even but even if not so spacious, like kitchens, amusement, probably most of them are not like this.
Yeah.
I think I'm not a firefighter, so I cannot speak, but I assume it's not as a high quality as you have. And of course, sirens and trucks. And
every house
lights.
Is different. Every house is different.
Definitely.
Some is not as big as this. Some is very small, like one room. You know, there's not anywhere to go. So,
yeah. So everything depends on the localization.
Location and resources and what we have. These are just some old pictures. So our original firehouse, so this is our second house.
Mm-hmm.
Our first house is over on Racine and Roosevelt, right around the corner over here, is on the east side of Racine. But now it's like a fire art museum, I think they made it into. But these are all old pictures from the original firehouse, Fire 18, Engineering.
Amazing.
Yeah.
wall of memories.
I always find it funny that they had to frame a toilet and put that on their wall. I'm like, I don't know how to explain that to people.
But apparently,
I know. I'm like, apparently we need to explain, like, this is what our toilets used to look like.
It just like it's just men.
Yeah.
Men are always men.
That's our toilet.
So. It goes beyond that with firefighters.
Oh my gosh. They even have a fire pole. We don't have a fire pole. The fire pole out there is just for the set. It doesn't even go anywhere.
Yeah.
It just goes to the ceiling and that's it.
Was that the fire pole that's out there, was that from a different fire hose?
I don't think so. I think that came in from the shows that they just put it there for their own props and stuff. Because a lot of stuff that they bring in, it's theirs. What you see in the show, it's probably not ours. They probably brought it in. They take all our stuff, like couches, whatever's out there. They have a truck, and they'll do like a switcheroo. Like they'll take our stuff, and put their stuff out there. And then we'll take our rigs, and we have a white tent on the other side over here, and we'll put all our rigs, like the Ambo, the Engine, the Chief, everybody goes over there, and they'll bring in their rigs.
So you have a defined ambulance?
So we have the Engine, and then we have an ambulance. I don't think they're home right now, but we're paramedic equipped on the Engine. So a lot of our calls are mostly EMS. It's busy over here, especially summertime. It gets really busy. So
it's just, I've never had the experience of going to a fire department that's both the ambulance and in Duluth they have the separate company, Mayo, does the ambulance.
Yeah, no, the Ambo here is part of the
Está enfrente de la iglesia. Esas son fotos en esa estación de antes. Yo ya estoy ahí, pero no sé qué está ahorita.
Era un lugar para. So, but there's no private ambulances that come out. I don't think there's any, but in any case, we've always, if it gets really busy during the summer, we'll get extra ambulances, but that's still through the Chicago Fire Department. Yeah. But I know what you're talking about. Like, you know, there's like concerts and stuff where those private ambulances are hired and stuff, that we don't do that.
So. You get to choose which, like, you're specifically set for the ambulance that's. Like
they assign you. So whenever you graduate from the fire academy, like they'll send you to whichever fire engine, fire truck. But then there's a difference with a paramedic. There's a paramedic academy and then a fire academy. So they kind of go through a little bit different scenarios. So.
Ooh, a weight room.
Sorry. No, you're good.
So it's just the fire station just possess that free vehicles for that moment, or it's just presented? They are presented for that moment.
For here.
For service. Yeah.
Our ambulance isn't here right now. Okay. So we have the deputy district chief, the fire engine. Sometimes we have the district chief here. He's in a black buggy. The ambulance, and then we have a high-rise rig that has certain tools on there for high-rises, fans and extra tools if we need to give extra support for a bigger fire. We'll have it. There's some pictures from the show on here.
I just know that that actor, I don't know what's his name and last name, but I remember him from the House and the Doctor.
Oh, okay.
So I recognize, I started watching, because he's playing there. So
yeah.
To be honest, like after two or three seasons, it became boring.
Yeah, I know. Okay. It's hard for me to be interested in something like that.
Yeah, definitely.
I'll say, like, for my family, I have two brothers that are also firefighters.
This is fake, by the way. You can hold it if you want,
it's good.
Some props of what they use on the show.
That's
and stuff,
cool.
So they made replicas of it. And then, what's it called, the slam again, or slam, what do they call it in the show?
I don't know.
I don't watch it enough.
Oh man, I think they call it slam again.
Well,
you
can still hurt somebody if you will try.
Oh, yeah. I mean, if you really need to, you can probably hurt somebody, but it's super light. But this is what we carry on the engine at the end of X.
Yeah, it can be helpful for my Chevrolet when I cannot open my door.
I don't think it will hell, but
Chicago by Schultz and use a Heligan bar.
Yeah.
Heligan bar.
Yeah, so it's a lot heavier than that.
I don't like my camera because I have reflection.
So when my family watches the show, they'll poke fun at the little things that are incorrect.
It's hard to watch. I know.
It's kind of fun if you look at it in that light of like, it's a show.
I think the first time I was watching, my daughters were watching my facial expression. They're like, Mom? I'm like, yeah, we don't do that. But the actors, actresses, they're really cool people. We get to meet them occasionally. They're just like so down to earth. Very respectful. They have a lot of fun.
Well, so this is the first question is, so they probably rent, yeah? So you rent the fire station and you have specialists next to you. Why you don't ask if something is correct with that movie?
Oh, no. I can't. I know. I keep my mouth shut.
No, they should ask you.
Some of the guys are like really good and experienced. Like, they'll train with like squad or like whatever outside of here. Just to get kind of more of a realization, like, okay, this is real, this is what happens. But the show, I mean, it's Hollywood, you know? It's like, they have to make it interesting if they
made it so.
Like, even we were watching Ladder 49, mm-hmm. and the guys were on the roof, and you see the roof is not stable, so, and he just keep going, why? There is... Why you're going there? And he fall down. Oh, and everyone worried. Why you went there?
Like, why are you so? I know.
Yeah. So that kind
of. You see, some guys are like jumping from roof to roof with like their whole gear on and tanks. And
yeah.
I don't know.
It's hard to watch.
Like that, but whatever. Yeah. But then there's this like the history of our SCBAs, like throughout
Amazing.
The years, what the guys have worn.
So what is the older to the newest?
Because I know. Guys always like the Scott. I think the size of our bottle now is like this, but a different mask. They don't have what we have right now on the wall. But guys always like the Scott.
Mm-hmm.
We carry 45-minute bottles. I miss the 30-minute bottles. They're much lighter, mm-hmm. but it's, you know, more air the better, obviously.
Yes. How big they used to be before?
You know what? When I got on, they were smaller, but now mm-hmm. we keep on going up in size. So now we're about that size, approximately. And our harnesses are a little bit thicker too.
Is it about 50 pounds?
I don't know. I mean, we had a 45-minute bottle. I don't know how much of that would be equivalent to pounds, because that's going per PSI.
If I can ask you mm-hmm. during your service. If you remember, first thing, which is probably I will do upside down the what is the happiest moment
at
being an operator, not the worst action where you were, but the happiest, which you remember to be a paramedic. Last time, the first thing which you remember.
Well, I'm assigned to the fire engine, but I think it's just being around the guys, being around. This is another mm-hmm. family, you know.
Yeah.
Your family away from your own family, so it's just.
You don't have to argue with mom.
Oh yeah, you'll argue, you'll laugh, you'll cry, and whatever. But I think ultimately I hear a lot of like even retirees saying that they miss just being around the guys, being around the kitchen table and just having, you know, a card game or just kind of mm-hmm. BSing all day long. But you know, but I mean the fires are fun. I love the fires. But
so you are a hot girl.
Yeah, I love going to work. So can't beat it. This is one of the best jobs that you could have.
Great.
Yeah.
Is it a trope, a sentence when all time there is nothing? You have to prepare yourself for something bigger. Like you have lazy days and nothing has happened.
Yeah, it's kind of rule. Everybody, I think every firehouse around the city has like their downtime, and that's when you want to kind of. You know, if you have spare time, educate yourself, you know, mm-hmm. pull up. You never stop learning on a job. And yeah. that's the fun part of it. There's always something new to learn. You know, especially when if you want to become a lieutenant or a captain or a chief, you got to keep on studying. And so mm-hmm. it's just kind of educate you a little bit further. It's fun. You get to learn new things, you know, test out new equipments and learn different techniques to pass down to the next generation. So, yeah, excuse me. So, I don't know. There's a lot of happy moments. I mean, there's bad moments too, like with any job that you have. Like, there's your ups and downs. So, but it's worth it. It's worth being on here.
Great. Thank you for your service. We are really, really appreciate that somebody cares.
Mm-hmm.
Like, for me, I'm from Poland. So, public healthcare is public. You don't have to worry if you have surgery. When you are working, you automatically are forced by government to pay your insurance.
Wow.
But your insurance cover you if you need a heart operation like my dad needs right now, or operation, you pay nothing.
Right.
Of course, you have to wait sometimes. If you are not in, your life is not in danger right now, you have to wait 2 years for surgery or 6 months, depends. But here, like first, because I'm foreigner, health insurance. Like, even in Poland, everybody tries to help you.
That's
depends
great.
On the quality. It's not they counting like money. It's the, here you afraid to call ambulance.
Yeah.
And then my question is, so you see, I am driving. I see an accident, and it's my kind of joke. Call ambulance or not? If guy is already almost dead, let him die. But he will rescue. He will got bill. Oh, we saved you, and he will got a heart attack. Then he will die again. So it's not worth it.
Yeah.
So really, thank you for your. It's probably we won't meet another time. I'm as a traveler. I really appreciate every second with people, open people who I met, and a prayer for them, for the protection.
No, thank you.
So really, really, really appreciate that me and Abigail too.
Yeah. No,
to
I'm glad that you guys came to visit. That's very nice of you. Thank you. Prayers are always needed around here, that's for sure.
Yeah.
Did you say you wanted a patch before I forget?
Yeah, I'll take one. Yeah. I texted my mom.
Richard Zysko. Witkowski. Tak, jak Polak szuka polskich nazwisk zawsze w napisach końcowych. Ja se nagrywam, ale guzik widać. Muszę ją tam dogonić, składzik na miotły, physical training i szatnie łazieneczki. Ale super, no na to nie byłem przygotowany, że będziemy mieć tutaj wycieczkę za frajer jeszcze do tego, także i to na planie, jak z wspomnienia to oglądam może dwa serie i potem się znudziło. Ale no super, po prostu super, superowo. No i pachnie obiadem. Nie będziemy im przeszkadzać. Centrum dowodzenia. Kamery. Super.
One thing is that if one way to do it is if you mail in a patch and leave a return address and ask if you can make a trade. Usually they're pretty respectful.
Yeah.
If we just gave out patches, we're gonna help. It'd be gone. It would just be gone. I would if I could, trust me.
Guzik widać, cholerka.
Oh gosh. Nice. Well, that's good. But my daughters don't like visiting me at all. They've been just grown up in this whole thing. I'm like, oh, come and visit me. No, mom. Oh man, my youngest is 13, and then I have a 20-year-old and a 23-year-old. Yeah. They didn't know.
Yeah.
And so I've been trying to get.
No, to pewnie, że jest paramedic stuff. Ale mam materiał na kanał Silence. Na dworze jest 40 stopni, 39 stopni po prostu w cieniu. Okej, to się wycofujemy. Nie lubię być abuzywny. To jest niesamowite.
No, another thing for me is I've talked about too much barf and maggots and stuff, things that should stay inside of the body.
Yeah, I know. I can't prepare anybody for it. It just happens.
But it's fine because it gives you a good, even though I wouldn't want to go into that as a profession, but it gives you a good understanding of, stuff happens, you gotta deal with it.
It's a real world. Yeah. I know. That's the hard part, is to understand it. Not always peaches.
Well, cool. I hope you enjoy. When did you get transferred?
Well, I transferred here in October, but I've been at November will be 11 years I've been at the job.
Yeah.
So this is my fourth house. I came here to, because I was kind of away from a downtown area, and so when you're away from that, you kind of lose sense of how everything's run and operated. Yeah. So I'm like, you know what, I gotta get closer, especially for promotional purposes. I gotta get back there and just, see how it is and stuff. So that's how I landed back here. So
I have a question.
Yes.
How much do you spend to fill up your engine truck for gasoline?
For here, no, the city pays for everything. So we just gotta take it down and fuel it up and that's
Can I sign up for the list? Because we're from Minnesota, I think we have $2.72 per gallon and he was free.
I know,
came with three gas canisters, 5 gallons each one, so I'm prepared, for 2 days.
Yeah.
It's Polish, and you got to greedy to spend. I won't spend $5 per gallon.
I've spent more than one dime on
that. Exactly.
I know. That's so funny.
Thank you so much for your time, for your patience, and for your colleagues. Said one guy from Europe, far away.
Yeah, I'll let him know. Actually, I'll tell the captain because he'll.
I really know where we pose, and I don't like when somebody was walking me. It's like bothers me. So I can exactly try imagine how do you feel sometimes. Oh, again, that's stupid.
No,
camera.
No, not at all. We love it when tours come through and stuff. We meet people
so it's
from
amazing.
All over, so it's fine.
Amazing.
Yeah, it's
something.
All good.
That is the difference between cultures. You have American culture is way more open than Polish, from my own experience.
Yeah.
And it's easier to live between Americans, in my opinion.
Yeah.
It's I love your culture. It's amazing. Thank you so much.
All right, guys. Well, have a good night.
Take care.
Have a good
night.
Thank you. It is a phrase. I wish you as many returnings as driving to the sea. The same amount of coming back as you are going to this. I know the translation makes sense.
No, it makes sense. I get it. No, that's very nice.
Have a great life. And
likewise. Like, enjoy your time in Chicago. As much as you can.
Thank you.
Bye.
Take care.
All right. Bye-bye.
An ambulance came back. How you like it? How did you like? How
oh,
do you like?
Nice. It's actually kind of a small station.
It looks really huge. To me. No, także pół godzinki. Tam jest jeszcze fajny picture z góry. To się szybko jeszcze trzasnę. No, także. Mam nadzieję, że się wam też podobało. To jest spontaniczny po prostu vlog, nieprzygotowany. Nie chce mi się po prostu tego robić, bo nie mam czasu, żeby to przerobić. Mam jeszcze moje problemy po prostu do rozwiązania życiowe. Mój Ford jest dalej rozwalony, także nie mam nagrywek z wyjazdów, przyjazdów, nie mam nic. No ale taki spontaniczny vlog, mam nadzieję, że się wam spodoba. Napiszcie mi w komentarzu, co sądzicie. I to nie jest komentarz o zasięgu, bo jak widzicie, to nie mam zamiaru z tego czerpać żadnej korzyści materialnej. To jest po prostu for fun i po prostu dla rozrywki, tak, własne hobby. Oczywiście nie wziąłem w ogóle stabilizatora, więc sorry. Za jakość filmu mamy tu, jeszcze tutaj szczelimy na 15 sekund widok na Chicago. Także jesteśmy w ogóle w drodze z domu Kevina po raz drugi w moim życiu. No, także filmowo. Dziękuję wszystkim za uwagę i trzymajcie się. Cześć.